Tima says, "Thanks, guys. I'll leave the rest to you." Aven says, "Wait!" Henchman says, "Hey, don't look over there! I'm your enemy, right here!" Is that your idea of taunt? Here we go. Hatchet Man and Voodoo Magician. Alright, well, let's do the deadly. I don't know which one's tougher. Maybe Voodoo Magician A. I always tend to take down the wizard types first. And the rest of us will focus on B. Ouch! Stone blast? Whoa! That's not good. Miss? That's good. What were we fighting? B, I think? Voodoo Magician B? Should finish killing him. Actually, Mile will heal, Muse. Alright, we got rid of two of the magician men. Double lunge. Oh my god, 3 points left on Mile. Oh, it's a good thing he missed. Let's attack Hatchet Man A. He's going after Mile. Mile. Wait, that's not. Well, that's not Mile. That's Marty, who's so low. Alright, so let's heal Marty. Yeah, and you know what? Alright, let's go back. I'm getting the portraits mixed up with the avatars here. Alright, so Marty is being attacked. Let's hit Hatchet Man B. And heal Marty. Man B, wow. You guys are tough. The most dangerous enemies so far. Alright, still attacking Hatchet Man B. We'll heal Muse. We'll do a deadly on Hatchet Man A. Get rid of the Hatchet Man. Alright, one down. That guy's still kicking? Oh my god. Yikes! Maya will heal himself. I just want to get rid of this hatchet man. Oh my god, we finally got him. Guys are tough. You know, even. Nice. Even level 7. Maya level 7. And Morty level 7. And Muse level 7. And we got. Oh, we got a SP Arcanum 3. Wow. Muse says, I think we're done here. Even says, but we left the female ringleader get away. Henchman says, damn, it's not over yet. Shannon yells, ah! Did you run into the wall? Hey, I didn't do anything. You, says Mile. Nice. Ow! Whew! Avon says, I think he's really dead this time. These guys are so violent. Mile says, are you okay? She's gonna think Mile is the prince. Ugh. Mile says, she's awake. Are you okay? My prince! Huh? You're my prince! Well, what's going on? You really came! I'm so happy! My prince, what is your name? I'm Mile. You're Shannon, right? Why are you calling me prince? Because you're my prince! You and I are destined to be together. What? Avon says, come on, everyone, let's go. Right, says Muse. Morty says, we should leave them alone. Mile says, huh? No, please. Wait! Shannon's mother says, oh, thank you, thank you. Shannon's father says, I don't know how to thank you. This is part of being a princess, says Muse. I'm glad nothing worse happened. Please spend time with your family today. Thank you, princess, says Shannon. Well, Mile, thank you very much. Please stop by at our house later if you can. Avon says, ha ha ha, you're popular, Mile. You think it has nothing to do with you? Muse says, well, it's all settled now. We let the boss, Fatima, get away, but we captured her henchmen. The Syamseal Gang will have to stop their activities for a while. Mile says, we can finally go see Sage Dinerken. It took us so long, says Avon. Muse says, let's get going then, Avon. General Deeren says, yelling again, Your Highness! I can't let you use this confusion to make your escape. It slipped my mind because of the situation, but it's a heavy charge to leave the castle without permission. Muse says, why didn't you forget about that forever? I'm not senile, at least not yet. You need to go back to the castle with me. I'm sure His Highness will be relieved when you're home. Listen, General, let's make a deal. You forget about seeing me here. It's time to give up, Princess. If His Highness is very mad, I'll mediate between you two. Dang. I guess I can't do anything about it. Avon, Mile, and Morty? Avon says, what is it, Princess? I wouldn't call it a comfortable trip, but I was never bored with you guys. Oh, don't leave. I want to show my gratitude anyway. Avon says, thanks a lot. We had fun, too. Miles says, you helped us pass the qualification exam, too. Marty says, I had a good experience, too. Deeren says, I'll make sure to tell His Highness about your contribution. Why don't you stop by at the guild? Your reward should arrive soon. Muse says, bye now. Hope to see you again. Muse left the party. Ah. Bummer. Avon says, she's gone. I'm gonna miss her, says Mile. She was a pretty good person, despite what happened. Marty says, I think she's gonna be a magnificent queen. I've got a lot to learn from her. Marty says, oh yeah, he's still talking. I feel like I've learned something from this incident. Until now, my goal was to pass the exam to become a bureaucrat and be a politician, but I don't think much about what I'm gonna do as a politician. On the contrary, Her Highness was focused on what she has to do as a princess. I want to learn such an attitude from her. Avon says, I'd respect her more if she wouldn't make so many insults. Miles says, you should talk. You're just as bad as she is. Marty laughs. So what are you guys going to do now? I know you want to visit Sage Dinerken. Avon says, we're going to travel all over Elfilden. I've got lots of things to do. Marty says, you've become an adventurer at such a young age. I'm sure you'll be able to achieve your goals with this journey. But since you're traveling, you should try and enjoy it a little. Don't just focus on your goals. See the sights, too. I don't mean be reckless, but find a path that will let you to accomplish your goals, and that will be fun. Oh my god, translation's dying over here. This is a small piece of advice from me. Avon says, yes. I'll try my best. Miles says, thank you for everything, Marty. Same here. Says Marty, I know we'll see you again. Marty left the party. Wow. Bummer. Well, let's go talk to everybody again. He just sells things. It's good to open my shop without worrying. Come around to the front of the counter to see our good products. Yet I just bought these people's stuff, too. I assume he has the same stuff. Let me just check. Oh, right. I want to sell a couple things. Oh, right. Wow. Yeah, the SP Arcanum 3. Pills made of crystallized high-purity spells restores magic points completely. Awesome. Did they drop their stuff? They might have dropped their stuff. Let's sell the power emblem because we have the wrist thing. What was the thing that we... Oh, silver anklet. Right. Both of them. Oh, three of them. Let's see what we have. Can improve anything here. Yeah, they dropped their stuff off. That was nice of them. Okay, so I can get Avon the late shield. Well, those attack goes way down. I'm not gonna not give it to him then. Mile already has one. Okay, so we're gonna sell a light shield. And leather armor, because they both have. Let's just stop there before I forget, and we'll go back. You could save it just in case new party members, but let's just get rid of it. Alright, I'm gonna sell this as well. I don't know about the belt. Thank you. And leather armor. Oh, wait. Okay, so nothing better for that. Alright, I didn't want to give him the light shield, right? And then leather armor, they both have already. Power wrist. I have another power wrist. The magic defense doesn't go down that much, but the attack goes way up, so I'm gonna give Mile the power wrist as well. Leather boots. Okay, I'm gonna sell the leather cape, leather boots, and silver anklets. What about the chain belt? I don't think anyone here can use the chain belt. I'm gonna save it. I think that's for Muse. I am gonna save that for her. Okay. Anything else I want to sell? Oh, arms. Oh, it's a whip. Never mind. It's not an armor piece. I'm gonna save that for her. Thank you very much. We'll go rest here. I won't forget about what you did for us. Thank you very much. By the way, you look tired. Please take a rest at my house.
Yes.
Thanks to you all, peace in this village was restored. Oh, I'm glad things worked out fine. That lady, I heard she's a princess, right? She's beautiful and cool, but I feel like the image I had of what a princess is supposed to be has been shattered. I understand that, says Avon. Totally. Totally, dude. Tessa says, I didn't know that Princess Meldine was such a tomboy. The late Queen Uriel looked feminine, so I always imagined that princess would have the same personality. But she's the only heir, so it may be good that she's active. I don't remember asking your opinion. Okay, so here's... what's her name? And parents. Shannon. I heard that you saved my daughter, along with the princess. I don't know how to thank you. It's not a big deal, says Avon. Miles says, I did what I had to do. How humble and bracing these young men are. I don't care which one, but why don't one of you marry my daughter? Huh? They both say together. You guys are strong and brave. Very ideal for my son-in-law. Mother says, thanks to you all, we can have dinner together as a family. Thank you very much. Shannon says, "Ah, I can't believe the prince of my dreams came to rescue me. I will never forget this day." Miles says, "Excuse me. I'm not the only one who saved you. Avon helped." Avon says, "Oh no, I can't take the credit. You were so brave. You can knock down bad guys with your boomerang in the blink of an eye." Avon's doing this on purpose. "You're my hero, Mile." Oh, forget this, Avon. "Mile, thank you very much." Alright, well, we came by to visit. Can we go to that sage's house now? Oh, here's that green hair kid. Hey, wait! Wait! Stop moving. "Thank you for saving Shannon. I'll become strong like you guys. I'll protect Shannon next time." Alright. Prayer Woods. Monsters are afraid. That's an interesting song. That one's not afraid. What's over here? Oh, what'd you find? Been a while. No, I don't need that. Oh, nice! A green crystal. And 100 rose. Sweet. Crystal containing wind power inside increases resistance against wind attack. Sweet. We don't have to buy it. Very interesting song. Nice! Another silver anklet. Things are a dime a dozen, aren't they? Go around. Oh crap. We threw it away. We don't want your crap, kitty. Oops. Royal powder. How's that? Used by the royal family, awakens unconscious while fully restoring power. Huh. So it's like a stimulant and heals you to full, I'm guessing. I don't know why we care, it's used by the royal family. Oh. Don't need that either. Sage's Mansion. Miles says, "Big house. Is this the mansion of Sage Dinerken?" "Looks like it," says Avon. "Hello. Is Sage Dinerken home?" A voice says, "The door is open. Come in freely." Okay, here we go, coming in freely. See, bookshelves. And more bookshelves, ooh. What looks like books about the prescription of medicines are lined up. Not this book. Oh, it goes outside. Oh, interesting. Oh, that must be the sage. We're messing around in his backyard over here, what little there is of it. Oh, there's another thing. What looks like documents regarding botany and biology are lined up. No books we can actually read? I should look here. There are various dictionaries lined up. I have never seen you before. What do you need from an old hermit? Sage Lemurus sent me here. He told me to meet you and receive your teachings. Sage Lemurus? You must be Avon then. So, do you know about me? He just said your name. Sir Lemurus and I communicated through letters. Your coming here means Sir Lemurus must have passed away. Yes. He took his last breath very peacefully. The world lost another great man, Dinerken says. Please have a seat. Tell me what happened in detail. I was watching stars the night of the full moon when I saw an amber-colored star burning down in the western sky. That's the sign that someone who is warm-hearted has died. I was worried that it could be Sir Lemurus. Unfortunately, I was right. Your grammar and spelling leave much to desire, sir. Avon says, Grandpa Lemurus told me to come and receive your teachings right before he died. And he also told me to deliver this to you. Oh! Cabessa, the head of Bardas. This is the great spirit which holds eternal wisdom. Please take this, says Avon. I will humbly take charge of it. Sage Dinerken put Cabessa in his pocket. It's small. By the way, you said you wanted to receive my teachings, but what do you mean? I'm on a journey to find someone. My only sister. We were separated when Cathedral was attacked all those years ago. Oh, that cathedral. The library at that cathedral called Cathedral. Never mind. By any chance, do you know of Emel's whereabouts? The old man said that she is being targeted by the power of darkness. What kind of people are they? Why is Emel being targeted? I want to know everything. I see. Then I'll tell you what I can. First of all, I don't know of Emel's whereabouts. Her whereabouts are top secret inside the church, too, so there is no way I could know since I'm an outsider. Oh. But I know why your sister is being targeted. She is called the Durga's daughter. Durga's daughter. You've heard of the Durga, right? A goddess, the mother of all living things, the great ruler of the four spirits, a guard of the realm of Hades who rules life and death. Her ideas have been passed down, but those ideas are just one aspect of her. The gods exist far beyond our imagination. It's fair to say that they live in another world, a different dimension, really. Avon says, wait, I don't understand. Miles says, you mean fish are to humans as humans are to the gods. We can never live in their world, and they could never live in ours. The sage says, your example hits the point very well. The gods created Earth and all the creatures that live here, but the gods cannot enter our world because it would cause chaos. What the gods can do is cause a little stir called a miracle with influence, not direct contact. the role of Durga's daughter is to influence. That is, she exists to cause miracles for Durga, because Durga cannot enter our world. Avon says, that little Emel? No way! I don't know if it's true or not, but the Bardist Church and the Power of Darkness, which attack Cathedral, believe so. What is the Power of Darkness? What are they going to accomplish by abducting Emel? The sage says, what are you going to do if you know the answer? Huh? Your sister's fate is more than she can bear. Any normal person that had that kind of fate would probably lose their life. Avon says, I'm not scared. You may lead the enemies to Emel if you search for her carelessly. Then, do you think you can protect her? Are you confident enough to face the enemy which turned Cathedral into a pool of blood? One way of putting it. Avon says, I promised her that I would protect her. Miles says, Avon. The sage says, one who understands the darkness can get closer to it, but are you ready for that? Although you are healthy mentally and physically, you are still an ordinary human. Therefore, I can't tell you anything more without putting you in danger. I'm sorry about Sir Lemuris, but this is my decision. No way, says Mile. Sage Dinerken, please think it over. Avon has been dreaming of reuniting with Emel since he was a child. You can't just tell him to give up. Avon says, Mile, it's all right. Let's go. Wait, Avon. I thought I would be able to gain happiness if I could be reunited with her. But I was too optimistic. I'm not ready to get into all of this. Avon, we'll excuse ourselves. Thank you for telling us all of that. All right, says the sage. I'm sorry I could not give better news. Well, it's weird to hear this cheerful music after that. I'll take charge of Cabessa with full responsibility. Be careful on your way back. Well, we can't just give up. Jumping on his beds. We're just gonna head back to... We're gonna head back to, what do you call it? Filden? Just checking around one more time before we go, because... It's actually quite a while back to Filden. Unless something's gonna happen in the town. Yeah. The game ends here. The end. Avon gives up. Thanks for playing. Miles says, Avon, are you sure you're okay? Are you going to give up on looking for Emel? No way! I could not argue with Dinerken. He could see that I am not ready. I'll visit him again after I cool down. Okay. That's okay, I guess. Should we go back to the capital for now? Good idea. Okay. So next episode, I guess we're heading back to Filden, guys. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always... Sick adventure.